This week, during an interview, Ron DeSantis lashed out at Donald Trump, saying that Donald Trump is totally fine with weaponizing the government against people he doesn't like. Now, DeSantis was specifically talking about the Colorado Supreme Court ruling that, of course, kicked Donald Trump off the ballot when he said that, you know, obviously this is unfair, this is not right, and that this is weaponization of the government. But then he took the shot at Trump. But let's just be clear. Trump is fine with weaponization if it's against people he doesn't like. If one of Trump's competitors was removed by a state Supreme Court, is there any chance in hell he would remove himself in solidarity? He'd spike the football. Now let's back up, right? The spike the football thing, would he, you know, pull himself off in solidarity? DeSantis is right. No, he wouldn't. But Trump is fine with weaponizing the government to go after people he doesn't like. Ron DeSantis is correct about that as well. Trump has been very clear that he is going to abuse his power if he gets back into office to go after people and even news organizations that he doesn't like. Trump is, again, crystal clear about that. He said the Democrats opened Pandora's box, so he'll do the same thing. But here's the thing that gets me. Ron DeSantis didn't mention that he's literally already been doing that as the governor of Florida. Like, how dare Trump say he'll use the government to go after people he doesn't like? Kind of like me when Disney pissed me off, so I took away all their privileges in the state, even though they're one of the largest employers of the state. They're one of the main draws for tourism in the state. Yeah, I said screw them because they were mean to me. Oh, and by the way, I also fired that prosecutor who didn't like me, and now I'm being sued for that. So yeah, not to mention, you know, all the book banning that I don't like. I don't like these books, so they get banned. I don't like the LGBTQ community, so I've gone ahead and legislated them out of existence in the state. But yeah, Trump would weaponize the government to go after people he doesn't like, right, Ron? Because that's what you're telling us. DeSantis is mad that Trump can say these things, that Trump can threaten to weaponize the government and get away with it, but DeSantis can't. And maybe it's because DeSantis is so bad about it. DeSantis is so overt about it. But maybe it's also because the people understand Trump doesn't have power right now and DeSantis does. And we have seen what happens when people actually weaponize a government to go after people they don't like. It's happening right down here in Florida and has been for years since Ron DeSantis took office. He has abused his power as governor. He has a Republican-controlled state legislature that has been there pushing him on the entire way. And now he's mad that Donald Trump wants to do the same thing. Nobody should be doing it. We're suffering down here in Florida because of Ron DeSantis' decisions. So it's irresponsible and, of course, hypocritical for not only him to not mention that he's done that, but it's exceptionally irresponsible for the interviewer to not mention that Ron DeSantis has done that as well. Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.